大家好，欢迎收听这一期的早安英文，我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
今天我们要来聊取名字，取英文名。
Right, choosing your baby's names.
对，那持续根据我们节目的朋友应该知道，关于名字我们已经聊过不止一次了。但是之前的节目中我们有讲到过，取名非常重要的一点呢， you'd better choose a name from the most popular names for your birth year. 所以新的一年来了，又会有一些新的变化和趋势了。
Although both of us don't have children yet, do you?
No.
Okay. I knew it, I was just making sure.We know that picking a baby's name is stressful business for new parents. You may want to find a title that's common for the era so that your child will fit in his or her formative years while still sounding quite unique.
完全同意。一方面呢，你想要给孩子取一个适合他出生年代的名字，不要显得太怪异。一方面呢，你又怕太普通，还是希望名字能够特别一点，所以非常的难。
So to help guide you along in the name picking process,We've assembled a list of some new names that are most likely to be popular in 2018. Okay, so first, I've heard that with names ending in an A, such as Amelia and Ella, are predicted to be popular for little girls this year.
Amelia, 给大家拼一下吧，这个发音怪怪的。A-M-E-L-I-A 和Ella 就是亚洲第一女子天团 SHE 那个陈嘉桦 Ella， 所以类似这种以 A 结尾的女孩的名字呢，今年可能会比较流行。What about little boys?
Well, I guess for boys, monikers starting with the letter R or TH, such as Ruben or Theo, are set to be top choices for boys.
九老师用了比较高级的一个词啊，叫 moniker。其实就是名字的意思啊 ，name。那么小男孩呢，可以取一些以 R 或者 TH 开头的名字，比如说 Ruben。Am I pronouncing it right?
Right.
R E U B E N。然后还有一个叫 Theo， T H E O。
And it seems gender-neutral names are rising in popularity this year.
可以理解，这个 gender neutral 它表示中性的，就是今年呢会开始流行比较偏中性化的一些名字。
So if you're looking for a gender neutral name that'll continue being cool for generations to come, Andy, Max, Alex, and Charlie are all on the list.
再重复一遍 ，Andy, Max, Alex, 最后一个叫 Charlie。如果你觉得这些过分大众的话，你还有一个选项叫做 Emerson, E M E R S Y N.
Oh, I've never heard of that before.I've heard the name Emerson, but usually it's E-M-E-R-S-O-N, so I guess they just decided to change the spelling. That's quite popular.
是的，这个名字呢，其实它就是 E-M-E-R-S-O-N 的一种新的拼写方式吧。另外呢，它还有一个 shorter version, 有一个短一点的版本，就是可以拼写成 E-M-E-R-Y 或者 E-M-O-R-Y.
Right, Emery. And some other names would be Sage, S-A-G-E,is also a gender-neutral name, which is trending upward right now.
对，再给大家重复一次 ,Sage, S-A-G-E.
And some other options would be for number one, Leia, L-E-I-A.
Princess Leia?
I guess so, yeah, from Star Wars.
对，就是那个电影《星球大战》莉亚公主的那个名字，它拼写是 L-E-I-A.
But this name also signifies heavenly flowers in Hawaiian.So if you like to think of babies as blossoming creatures of the earth, this might be a good name to go.
Next one, A-L-O-Y, 你可以读成 Alloy 或者 Alloy.
Right, like Emerson, you can shorten that to be Emery. Alloy or Alloy would be the shortened version of the traditional name Aloysius.
它同样是来自一个比较经典的名字叫做 Aloysius, 取了它前面的四个字母。
Right, next, a girl's name, Malia,has gained popularity over the last year or so.
It's also from Hawaii, 是一个来自夏威夷的名字。我记得前总统的大女儿吧，就叫这个 Malia Obama.
And Leo, there are a ton of different versions of the name Leo that are increasing in popularity.
比如说你可以叫做 Leon.
Or Lionel, or Leonidas.
或者 Leonardo, and for girls, Leona. 然后呢我们就不一一拼写了。
It doesn't hurt that Leo means lion because strength is definitely a desired quality for the coming generations.
因为这个 Leo 它其实有狮子的意思，尤其在那种童话或者寓言故事里面。但是这个并不是一个问题，因为狮子代表强大的力量嘛，是一个比较好的寓意。
And then we have celestial names like Luna and Nova. Luna is a name that signifies the moon and usually goes to girls, while Nova refers to a star or the sun, which has no true gender specification.
所以这个 Luna 它表示月亮，不知道为什么想起了王者荣耀。然后呢，它通常作为这个女生名，然后 Nova 表示星星或者太阳，男生女生都可以用。
And the last one for today, Harley.
这个听起来有点耳熟啊 ，Harley Quinn, right?
Well, I think more like Harley Davidson motorcycle.
去年那个自杀小队里边的唯一这个看点小丑女的名字就叫做 Harley.
Right, but it can also be suitable for boys because motorcycles.
对。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
所以听众朋友们，如果说今年有小 baby 要出生啊，或者说你的亲戚朋友里边有小 baby 要出生啊，可以从这些名字里边选一个自己喜欢的。那今天我们节目呢就到这儿了，我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
我们下次再见吧，拜拜。
We'll see you later.